His fingers would not move. There's nothing wrong with him. They were just paralyzed.
The unsteadiness continued until he was unable to practice, write, or perform. He grew thinner, even as doctors found nothing physically wrong.
Dorsey probably struggled with depression. He's trying to get his sacred music over, and it's not going over well. He's being called everything but a child of God. It sent him into what he called a nervous breakdown.
Dorsey was broke and even contemplating suicide. His wife urged him to seek solace in the church.
Nettie would try to get him to understand that he needed to leave the secular music alone and just go to the church until he followed God's will for his life. Nothing was going to work for him.
One morning, a friend who lived in the apartment below took ill and died later that night. The sudden death shook him once again. As Thomas Dorsey emptied his thoughts into the piano, a new connection between blues and worship took shape.